Good evening to all. My name is Srinivasa Murthy. I am working as an associate professor in Mechanical Engineering Department of Erode Sengunder Engineering College. Today's topic is natural frequency of vibration of a mechanical system. First of all, what do you mean by natural frequency of vibration? See, when a system is subjected to oscillatory motion without the involvement of an external force, then it is said to exhibit free vibrations. So, when the system is executing free vibration, the oscillations will happen at a particular frequency, and that frequency is what we call as natural frequency of vibration. So for every system, there is one inherent property of vibration called natural frequency of vibration. See, there are multiple methods by which natural frequency of vibration of a mechanical system can be computed. Today we will focus upon one such methodology called energy method to find natural frequency of a spring mass system. So let us take a spring mass pulley system. What is shown here is nothing but a pulley over which we have a belt which is suspending a mass. A mass is getting suspended with the help of a pulley and a belt system. The elasticity of the belt is considered by giving a spring-like construction with a stiffness value called K. So the elastic property of the spring is included in this physical modeling, and the movement of the mass can be fixed with the help of a coordinate x of t. And the rotation of the pulley, which will be taken as, we can take the rotation of pulley in anti-clockwise direction, and this can be measured with the help of the coordinate theta of t. So x of t represents the linear displacement of the mass, and theta of t represents the angular displacement of the pulley. So for such a system, how to find the natural frequency of vibration? We will use one method called energy. So in the energy method, according to this approach, the summation of the energies which are present in a system at any instant of time, it will always be equal to a constant. So for a spring mass pulley system, we can talk about Ke plus Pe is equal to constant, which means the summation of kinetic energy plus potential energy will always be equal to a constant. Now let us see what are all the kinetic energies present in the system. See, there is a rotating mass which is in the form of a pulley which will possess rotational kinetic energy, and there is a translatory mass which will be able to move in the vertically down, upward and downward direction, and this linear mass will be able to possess translatory kinetic energy. So the total Ke of the system will be given by Ke translation plus Ke rotation. So for this we can have an expression like the translatory kinetic energy of the mass is half m x dot square plus the rotational kinetic energy of the pulley is half I theta dot square. And what about Pe? The potential energy is possessed by the spring element, therefore Pe can be found like half into k square, where k represents the spring constant or spring stiffness of the spring element. So now we have this expression like Ke plus Pe equal to constant in expanded form, like half mx dot square plus half I theta dot square plus half kx square, and the summation will be equal to a constant. But if you inspect the equation, see there are two terms which are involving the variable of linear displacement x and x dot. And there is one term which involves the angular velocity based upon the angular coordinate theta. So it is better to convert all the three in terms of linear coordinate or all the three in terms of angular coordinate. So it is better to convert the linear coordinate in terms of angular coordinate. So what I will do is, I will try to find the relationship between x and theta. Suppose if the radius of the pulley is r, then we have this simple relation like the displacement of the mass, which is x, can be written as r times theta, which means that linear displacement of the mass can be written as the product of the radius of the pulley and the angular coordinate theta through which the pulley is able to rotate. From this we have x dot, which is a direct differentiation with respect to time as r into theta dot, and x double dot can be written as r into theta double dot. So we will use some these relations accordingly in this expression to convert everything in terms of angular coordinate. So the first term will become half m into, instead of x dot I have r theta dot whole square. Second term I will write as such. And what about the third term? This can be written as half k into, x can be written as r theta whole square. So this will be written as equal to cos theta. The next step in energy method is to differentiate the expression. So once you differentiate this expression, see what will happen. This becomes d by dt of ke plus pe. But what will happen to the right hand side portion? See, ke plus pe is equal to an arbitrary constant. But once you differentiate, then the right hand side will become equal to 0. So the unknown parameter vanishes into a 0 once you differentiate the left hand side portion. So this is convenient for us to get rid of the unknown constant. Hence, what I do is, I differentiate. So right hand side will become equal to 0. So once you differentiate, what happens? See, theta dot squared will come out as 2 theta dot times theta double dot. So 2 and a half will get cancelled. So the first term will be m r squared times, this will be theta dot. Again theta dot will be differentiated, which will become theta double dot. Similarly, the second term, theta dot squared, once it gets differentiated, it will give 2 theta dot multiplied by theta double dot. 2 and half will get cancelled. So what you will get is I theta dot multiplied by theta double dot. And what will happen to the third term? Half and this 2 will get cancelled. I mean the 2 which emerges out of differentiation of theta square. So what remains is kr square times theta multiplied by theta dot will be equal to 0. So if you see, the first term is the coefficient, has some coefficients related to theta double dot. Second term has some coefficients related to theta double dot, whereas third term is having some coefficient related to theta. And one more thing is, all three terms have one common thing, that is theta dot. Therefore, get rid of theta dot first. So, from what remains, we can group the equation mr squared plus I multiplied by theta double dot plus kr squared times theta will be equal to 0. You can rewrite this equation as theta double dot. I mean, the coefficient of theta double dot can be moved by dividing it throughout. The whole equation can be divided with the coefficient of theta double dot. So first term will become simply theta double dot. Second term will become kr squared by I plus mr squared. The whole thing multiplied by theta equal to 0. Now, the equation resembles the governing equation of a simple harmonic motion. So that simple harmonic motion's governing equation also let me write down here. That is omega double dot, sorry, theta double dot plus omega n squared times theta will be equal to 0. So this is the governing equation for any simple harmonic motion. And ours is nothing but a case of simple harmonic motion. And hence, when you take a direct comparison between the general equation for simple harmonic motion and the equation of motion which we have got for the spring mass pulley system, then we can easily figure out that omega n can be obtained as, you see, omega n squared is given by kr squared by I plus mr squared. Therefore, omega n will be nothing but under radical, it will be kr squared divided by I plus, I plus mr squared. So this will be the simplified expression for finding the natural frequency of vibration. But in most of the pulley systems, the pulley which we employ will be having a uniform diameter and uniform thickness. If that is the case, the mass moment of inertia I of the pulley can be written as half times capital mr squared, where r represents the radius of the pulley and m represents the mass of the pulley. So once you substitute this expression for I in this equation, you will get this expression as, I mean the expression for omega n as k r squared over, instead of mass moment of inertia of the pulley, now I am in a position to substitute half mr squared plus this will be small mr squared. So r squared, which is common in both the numerator and denominator, can be cancelled out. So you will get a very simplified expression like k divided by m plus capital M over. So this becomes the final form of the expression for natural frequency of vibration of a spring mass pulley system. Thank you.